Manmeet, and today's video is about Akashic records. A lot of questions get asked around why should we get our Akashic records read, how will it benefit us, what are the records, what do they hold. So this video is going to talk about the basic concepts of the Akashic records, and the subsequent video is going to talk about what you can expect in a session. Akashic records are like a library of all the past lives that your soul has led till date. All the lives that you've ever lived, every action you took, every thought, every decision is recorded in these records. These records are actually stored in the Akasha or the sky. A trained practitioner is trained to delve into these records with your consent and to draw out the two or three key lives that affect the circumstances or the challenges that you're facing today. Many people many times feel that they see or there seems to be a pattern to the challenges that they are facing. It could be financial, it could be related to health, it could be related to relationships, it could be related to many deaths in the family, cancers in the family, and many other such patterns. There are families who get robbed generation after generation. There are families who have chosen health as one of their karmic vehicle in this life. And the question why troubles people to no extent. Why is this happening to me? Why is my life like this? Why is this pattern repeating itself? I see others very happy, but this seems to be a particular pattern that flows in my life or my family's life. That is the time that you know that this has nothing or very little to do with this life, and it has a lot to be carried from the past life. And that is what and where Akashic records step in. If you feel you have such a pattern or a challenge that you are undergoing, you may seek an appointment for reading your Akashic records. There are two or three basic differences between reading the Akashic records and doing a past life regression session. One, in the Akashic records, the client is not hypnotized. He doesn't have to regress to go and visit his past life. The lives are read by the practitioner, and the time the client is here, the lives are presented to him as part of the reading. The second major difference is that in Akashic records, there is healing and clearing of the negative blocks and restrictions that may have affected you in the past life and is certainly looking to be a challenge in this life. The third thing is that Akashic record reading offers you a 21-day cleansing prayer that helps you bring the energy of this cleansing on the earth plane, which is the third plane. Typically, an Akashic record reading session takes about an hour to an hour and a half, depending on the discussion and the extent of the reading. What really happens in the reading, I will discuss in my next video. But for now, the importance of the Akashic records is twofold. One, it clears your past life negative blocks and restrictions, not karma. The second is that it gives you an insight into who you are at soul level. What is your soul blueprint? What is your soul DNA? What is it that you are carrying on your soul cellular memory that is affecting how you live today? What is your divine gift? And how can you, knowing that divine gift of your soul, channel a better life for yourself today? How can you use that gift to overcome the obstacles that you are facing today? So the reading is divided into three parts. The first part gives you an insight about your soul group, your soul family, and your soul contract. The second part talks about your past lives, channels three or four key past lives, and tells you how you were related to certain people in this life. The third part is the healing part, where we do the cleansing work and you are given the healing prayer to do for 21 days. What exactly happens in those sessions? Stay tuned in for my next video. Thank you.